Hello, welcome to the UltFone channel. A lot of users are angry that their iPhone keeps getting stuck spinning wheel. Sometimes even new iPhone have the same problem. If your iPhone doesn't respond, don't worry. I have some solutions for you to fix it. You can give it a try. Now, let's get started. Method 1. Force restart iPhone. This method works for many small problems. You can try it whenever you are. Take iPhone X for example. Press and quickly release the volume up button. Press and quickly release the volume down button, then press and hold the side button. Release the side button when the Apple logo appears. It only takes a few seconds. Usually you will come to the home screen without spinning wheel. If it doesn't work for you, please move to the next scenario. Method 2. Use iTunes. Updating your iPhone by iTunes is a useful way for many users to fix the problem. So we need to open iTunes on your computer. Then connect your iPhone to your computer. Here we should put iPhone into recovery mode if the computer doesn't recognize iPhone. So press and release the volume up button. Press and release the volume down button. Then press and hold the side button until you see the computer icon. Well, go back to iTunes. The option to update or restore pop-up appears on the screen. Note that we select update here. Then agreeing to these agreements. The firmware download will begin and then update your iPhone. This process usually takes half an hour. You can keep a good network and then take a break. Alright, it's completed. Let's check it out. Then we landing the normal screen. Although this method works, it often fails or waits too long. Fortunately, there is a more reliable and stable way. Method 3. Use UltFone iOS System Repair. UltFone iOS System Repair is a professional tool to fix iOS system problems. The whole process only takes 3 clicks. Now let's run it on your computer. Then connect your iPhone and put it into recovery mode. Go back to UltFone iOS System Repair, and then click Start button. Here we click Standard Repair to proceed. Then hit Download option to download iOS firmware. Okay, the firmware has been downloaded. Just click the Start Standard Repair and wait for it to update your iPhone. Well done, let's check it out. This time we successfully come to the normal screen. It's so easy, right? So guys, that's all for today's video. If you think this video is helpful, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, have a nice day. See you.